Okay, God bless you all. My name is Brother Jonathan Kale. I just want to share this word. Now, this word has to do with blasphemous voices. Okay, now this is the discussion that I'm going to give to you that the Lord explained to me. And I want you all to walk in confidence, mm-hmm. to walk in strength, to walk in encouragement, and be edified by this message. Because what they're going to do is they're going to speak in the airwaves. Okay, now we know that Satan is the prince of the power of the air. Okay, and with that being explained, he deals with the airwaves. And many can do this research. What they do, I'm gonna give you an example, like a gallery place. Okay, that's a place, you know, where a lot of youth hang out. Oftentimes, me and my brothers have preached there. We just preached there last night. Matter of fact, you know, just a lot of times people go to gallery place, or I'm not really sure of other places that are like that. But places where there's a lot of youth at. Well, what happens is that they when I say they, I guess, you know, the law, they have created this sensor, this sound, where only people who are like young, rebellious kids, maybe like 18, where they can hear it and you can't hear it. Okay, you might be 25. 26, 28, 29, 30, 40s, 50s, you can't hear it. But if you're like 18 and under, or 21 and under, you'll be able to hear it. And it's only for you. Okay, now. And then they also have these things where, like, you know, you plug it in the wall, because I had mice before, and you plug it in the wall, and, you know, the mice can hear this sensor, and they, like, it bothers them. And they don't want to be around. Or I heard about how you can do that with these with roaches. Okay, now this is all technology, and I told you guys in the past that, like, you know, a lot of this technology is from Satan. Okay, however, don't get me wrong, God can use it for his good. I'm not here to, you know, debate that, because God can use it for his good. But it's because what the devil meant for our evil, God turned it around for our good. That doesn't mean that is not what the devil meant for our evil. Okay, so initially, you know, the devil, he wanted to get us into this whole, you know, technology thing, you know, to trap us. Okay, and now, you know, this whole technology, and a lot of things are coming to pass. A lot of things are coming to pass. If you look at, I want to encourage you guys to, like, this is what to see if I'm a false prophet. This is what I want you guys to do, okay? Because, you know, some people have trouble receiving from me. This is what I want you to do. Type up, like, you know, or just go to my playlist and then type up, like, you know, if it's happening. I said that, I told you guys that animals were going to start attacking people, okay? In residential areas, it's happening, okay? I told you guys that it was going to be new STDs. It's happening, okay? I mean, you know, I don't have the technology thing going on where I can, like, show you videos of how it happened. Like Dr. O'Hara, who I bless God for, you know what I mean? He's a Kenyan African man. He has like a dread beard, and he has, like, you know, the head, whatever, like, you know, whatever. So anyway, but I'm just trying to describe him. But my point is that, you know, after he has people helping him. I don't really got all that, you know what I mean? I got some people helping me from time to time, but I don't really have all that. Like, he has a team. He has a ministry team with people who, like, probably just do that while he doesn't have to worry about that. He just prays and fasts and reads, you know what I'm saying? And he got other people putting it up online, and he'll tell them, yeah, it came to pass. And then, you know, like, his show comes on, and they're like, good morning, prophet of the Lord. And then he's like, good morning. And then he, you know what I mean? So he ain't got to do nothing. All he got to do is just tell people what the Lord is saying, and they'll film him and load it up, and it's all over. Well, I don't have that, and many men of God and women of God don't have that. I'm just, you know, some old guy. But that doesn't mean that these prophecies aren't coming to pass. You understand? They are. And so, you know, I told you guys in the past about satanic technology, okay? I told you guys in the past. And I mean, it's not that, you know, I said it out of my own power, but I'm telling you what the Lord is saying, and he shared with me, and I'm sharing with you. I'm saying what it was in the secret, in the housetop, okay, in the rooftop. And I just want you guys to know these things. I don't have those avenues, but if you guys, you know, type up my name, or put it like this, just go to my playlist, look at the video, and then go straight to the type up, like, you know, new STDs. You know what I mean? You see the insect video that I made about the woman, you know, and I said it was like a fly or something, but I took back the word fly because I just knew it was an insect. You know what I mean? And it skipped over Christians and stuff like that. Now you got Zika. You feel me? Like, this stuff ain't no coincidence, okay? And these are old videos from 2012 and 11 and 13 and 14 and 15, okay? So, you know, just look at the history. Look at Yemen, of how, you know, that word was given. And then look at the dates. Always look at the dates of what the news has to offer. And then look at the dates that I made it, okay? Look at the dates that the Lord gave it to me. Because even when I made it, that doesn't mean the Lord gave it to me on that day I made the video, okay? Because, you know, these are all real old recordings. It's just that, you know, sometimes I kind of get stubborn and I don't release the message in the time I need to. But anyway, you know, just look at those videos and then take notice, because I've discussed satanic technology, okay? Now, and it's growing, okay? They got an iPhone 7 coming out where the screen opens up, you know what I mean? And broadens, okay? But it starts off small like a regular phone, and then it goes open because it's in the back, it opens. Then you got a screen, you know, that kind of like, you could do it on your phone, in your hand, you could type on your hand. This stuff is crazy, like, it's all, you know, preparing you to have your mind conformed. Well, now jumping back to the whole thing with the voice and hearing the voices, hearing the sounds, you know, that get rid of the mice and get rid of the, you know, the roaches and get rid of the rebellious teens, okay, on the corner, you know what I mean? Well, what they're going to do, what the devil is planning to do, and this is not just a new word, but I'm giving it to you now because the Lord is reminding me to give it to you. But what they're going to do is speak blasphemous against the Holy Spirit, against God and Jesus. And it's going to be out in the airwaves. And you cannot, and it's going to feel like it's you, okay? And you cannot fall for this, okay? Don't walk in discouragement, okay? I've heard, I want to tell you, I'm Brother Jonathan. I'm a Christian like you, okay? I've heard many blasphemies of the Holy Ghost in my head, okay? I've always rechanneled it, removed it, got rid of it, because that stuff is not from God, and I believe that there's spirits that will try to program your mind to blaspheme the Holy Ghost, okay? There's spirits, so immediately, like, cast it down immediately. Even the mere preparation of your mind feeling like it's about to recognize that. There could be spirits of blasphemy, okay, among you, and you must get rid of this, okay? And, you know, don't entertain it, because it's going to be in the airwaves. Satan is the prince of the power of the air. Don't walk in condemnation, okay? There's going to be voices saying, kill yourself, you understand? All these things are going to be in the airwaves, okay? And this is technology, you understand? And you cannot fall into it because it's the devil's way, okay? Now, also, the Lord wanted me to let you guys know that they're going to start blaspheming the Holy Ghost on TV, on movies, in music, okay? It's going to be a stronger wave of blasphemy against the Holy Ghost. And let me go to scripture, because I believe scripture does speak about prophetically how blasphemies of the Holy Ghost or blasphemies, period. And you will not be forgiven. Just want to put that out there. That's the one thing that you will not be forgiven for. The apostle says, the apostle John says, this you not pray for, okay? There's some things that you can pray for, and there's some things you can't pray for. Now, blasphemies of the Holy Ghost, you can't pray for somebody who blasphemes the Holy Ghost, okay? Okay, so I'm kind of sporadic. I apologize. Should have been prepared. But that's 2 Timothy 3:2, okay? It says 2 Timothy 3:2. I'm going to read that as soon as it loads, okay? It says, okay, go straight to King James because I know some don't really say it the proper way. It says, for people will be lovers of self, lovers of money, boastful, proud, blasphemers, disobedient of parents, ungrateful, unholy. Okay. Now I just wanted to use scripture. That's 2 Timothy 3:2. Okay. Blasphemers. Okay. This is the discussion right now. Blasphemers. There will be blasphemers on TV, online. Okay. This is a programming. TV is a television program. Okay, they want you to be programmed into blasphemy. You're already hearing people curse God, okay? You're hearing it on cartoons. You're hearing it on, and they're cursing Jesus, but they're going to step it up to blasphemy of the Holy Spirit, okay? And as I say this without doing my research, and I'm not going to do my research, but maybe, you know, I don't care. Like, maybe somebody can, but I know that they probably already are doing it because, you know, that's just how I don't know. It's just, I could be wrong, but but anyway, nonetheless, it's not just going to be blasphemy of the Holy Spirit in the movies, blasphemy of the Holy Spirit in, you know, different entertainment like music and TV, but it's going to be in the airwaves. And so I want you all Christians, all of my beautiful beloved people in the body of Christ, to guard yourself, okay, from the blasphemous voices that you will be hearing, okay, in the airwaves, okay? It's going to be in the airwaves. Now, this might be in times later, in latter days, but this is not a Christian nation. This is a nation that already took God out of the schools. They already took God out of the law, you know? So you know, when you take God out, anything you replace, it must be placed with something else. Okay, so anyway, I just want you all to know this because I don't want you to, you know, feel like, well, I might as well kill myself. Well, I might as well, you know, give myself over to the mark of the beast. If this is not, it has to come from your heart. Okay, now you understand, it's not just the mere saying it, even though you better not say it, but it's the heart matter what caused the Pharisees to blaspheme through their accusations towards Jesus. Okay, it was in their heart. Okay, but what on God's green earth will cause you to say this out of your mouth? Okay, so it's what's going on in your heart. Okay, it's what's going on in your heart. From the abundance of the mouth, from out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speak. From out of the heart flows the issues of life. Okay. Amen. So, you know, I just want you all to know that. Yeah, amen. Thank you, Jesus. I want you all to just know that because this is real. This is the real deal. I don't want you guys to be deceived. I want you guys to walk in strength, power, you know. Amen. It says, from out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speak, okay? Amen. Thank you, Jesus. I knew that was the Holy Ghost. I knew it was. Okay. For out of the heart proceedeth evil thoughts. This is Matthew 15:19. Murders, adulteries, fornications, thefts, false witness, blasphemies. From out of the heart, okay? From out of the heart. This is the words of Jesus, okay? So if you don't feel this way in your heart and you're blaspheming the Holy Spirit, why would you say that, okay? So that's the thing that we have to question. Why would I say this, okay? So if you're hearing these voices and you don't feel that way in your heart, get rid of the thought. Get rid of it. Fast. To prove to God that this is not of you, okay? This is not where you stand, okay? Okay, we can't. If we were to see what's going on in the spiritual realm, boy, would we be a lot more understanding. Because the spiritual realm, I mean, there's tons of demons out there. So God bless you all. I love you. I want you to not feel the discouragement from the from the devil that he comes to bring, which is the wave of technology through the prince of the power of the air, through his technology of using these voices of blasphemy of the Holy Spirit. The same way how he uses these sensors, okay, that people cannot recognize, and that they use on dogs, or, you know what I mean, that the police use on rebellious youth, and also keep your heart, you know, guarded, and be very mindful of what you watch, because the blasphemous times of the entertainment world against the Holy Ghost are rising. Okay, God bless you all. In Jesus' name, I love you.